This video discusses the NVMe over TCP discovery options for PowerStore using PowerStore OS 3.0. Suzy is setting up a new NVMe over TCP environment with Dell PowerStore and Smart Fabric Storage software. In PowerStore OS 3.0, Suzy realizes that there are multiple NVMe discovery options to choose from when configuring the PowerStore networks. In this video, we will follow along with Suzy as she makes her decisions on the best option to use. Suzy's new NVMe over TCP environment is required to be highly redundant. She has both the PowerStore T storage appliance and the workload host connected to each switch in the environment. The top switch is SAN A, while the bottom switch is SAN B. In her environment, the centralized discovery controller is Dell's Smart Fabric Storage software. It is deployed in the workload host. In PowerStore Manager, Suzy has navigated to the Storage tab within the Network IPs page. She has already configured the storage networks, which connect to SAN Fabrics A and B. SAN Fabric A uses VLAN 100, while SAN Fabric B uses VLAN 200. Suzy now needs to determine the right NVMe discovery option to use for her environment. Suzy selects the first storage network and clicks the NVMe Discovery Options button. The Automatic Discovery Disabled option blocks all outbound and inbound PowerStore MDNS queries for discovery on the network. To configure NVMe over TCP, a user must manually enter the PowerStore port information within the centralized discovery controller. This causes a manual pull registration to the PowerStore to occur. This discovery option was first available in the PowerStore OS 2.1 release. Suzy wants to use Dell Smart Fabric Storage Software, or SFSS, to help simplify her end-to-end NVMe over TCP configuration. But this option requires her to manually add the storage system to SFSS. If any IP address changes on the storage network, Suzy will need to manually update SFSS with the new PowerStore information by running another pull registration with the updated IPs. Suzy decides not to use this option because of the manual updates that may be needed in the future. The Advertise DDC option disables the PowerStore appliance from running MDNS queries on the network, but allows hosts to discover and connect to the PowerStore appliance using MDNS. This allows a host to directly discover the storage without the use of a centralized discovery controller. This option should not be used if a CDC instance, such as Dell Smart Fabric Storage Software, exists within the network if direct host to PowerStore connectivity is established. Keep in mind that the Advertise DDC option does not allow Suzy to use SFSS. Also, none of the hosts in the environment currently support listening to NVMe MDNS requests. The Manual Configuration option disables MDNS, which blocks the PowerStore appliance from querying the network. This also blocks a CDC from automatically querying the PowerStore system. To register the PowerStore appliance with a CDC, enter the IP address of the CDC. After the IP is entered and apply is selected, the PowerStore Direct Discovery Controller sends a Kickstart Discovery request to the CDC instance and completes its registration. Although this option allows Suzy to use SFSS, she doesn't want to manually add the CDC IP address for each storage network in the environment. The Automatic Discovery of CDC option is selected by default when the storage network is created. This option allows the front-end ports of the PowerStore appliance to automatically discover and register to a centralized discovery controller on the current network subnet. This greatly reduces the overhead of manually registering the PowerStore appliance with the CDC. Suzy decides that this is her best option because it allows her to use SFSS, and any changes on PowerStore are automatically reflected within SFSS. In Suzy's environment, she can see which IP addresses were used by the PowerStore network by clicking the hyperlink in the Used IP column. Here she can see the 10.10.10 IP addresses that were used by PowerStore on SAN Fabric A. Because both storage networks are using the automatic discovery option, the CDC connections have automatically been established. By clicking the hyperlink in the CDC connections column, she can verify which storage IP is used to connect to which CDC IP. Here, both PowerStore 10.10.10 IPs connected to the CDC's 10.10.10.250 IP. Suzy also confirms the IP addresses used for SAN B and the connections to the CDC on that fabric. After configuring the NVMe discovery option on PowerStore, Suzy logs into Dell's Smart Fabric Storage software to confirm that the PowerStore front-end ports were automatically discovered. To view the PowerStore front-end ports, click the CDC Instances button and change to the CDC you wish to view. Next, select DDC. DDC stands for Direct Discovery Controller. This page shows the IPs discovered automatically by the software, or IPs that were manually registered. For each of the PowerStore IPs, KDCC is listed as the config type. KDCC stands for Kickstart Discovery Controller Connection. Any IPs listed with KDCC as the config type were automatically discovered and registered with the software. The Subsystem tab is used to display the NVMe subsystems discovered within SFSS. Here, the NQN IDs for each of the PowerStore ports are displayed. Information for SAN Fabric B on CDC Instance 2 can also be reviewed. The DDC tab shows that the IPs were automatically discovered, and the Subsystem tab shows the NQNs for the PowerStore ports on Fabric B. With the PowerStore appliance registered in SFSS, Suzy can now complete zoning in her environment. For more technical resources on PowerStore and SFSS, go to the Dell Technologies Info Hub and Dell Support site. Thanks for watching.